shots to a back hurt. Back shots. Throwing through the money till my hands hurt. Cash out. Wanna go on a date, you gotta dance first. Yeah, yeah. Take it to the paint, I gotta slam first. Yeah, yeah. She be acting stiff with the.
It's Coco and Ling Ling. You already know. And we're here to tell y'all about our Rolling Loud experience. Now, first, we want to discuss about getting prepared for Rolling Loud. Now, of course, you have to go shopping.
Gang is here to shop for Rolling Loud. We're at the mall trying to ball on a budget, of course.
We have $40.
But, you know, you want to think about what it is you're gonna get when you go shopping, because not only are you there for the concert, but you might be there to
go out
and experience Miami too. So we had stayed from the 9th to the 14th, but the concert was the 10th to the 13th. So the concert was gonna be 3 days. And we, that was what?
I thought that was your stomach or something.
No. But yeah, I think I took about 3 main outfits because of the days of Rolling Loud, and then like 2 possible going out outfits just in case. Like, because I wanted to pack very moderately because I didn't want to have like too much. Like,
I can't dress. I don't know. By the grace of God, I pulled together some outfits.
No, because that check-in was going to be a beast if we had too much stuff. Check-in when we got to the airport.
We paid for it.
We paid for it and didn't even use it because our dumb selves go straight to where security is and take all of our stuff with us. We got mad stuff thrown out because of that. Mad stuff.
None of us had our natural hair, thank God, because I would have to throw away my Ego Styler.
Natural hair all out.
But the glue for the closure, the gel, everything. Had to throw it away.
Mm-hmm. They did us dirty. But prepare yourself for that, please. Make sure you bring travel size stuff. We need to have that problem with you guys.
And if you're not trying to bring travel size stuff, put it in your suitcase and make sure that suitcase gets checked in. It's going under the plane, not carry on with you. You're allowed to bring whatever you want. They're not gonna check that bag. They're gonna check the bag that's carried on with you. So put all the stuff you're trying to sneak on the plane in the suitcase under the plane.
Right.
Not at your seat.
Won't end up like us because I was sick. Super sick. And then for your, you know, the payment of Rolling Loud, it's not to, like, if you're on a budget and you know that you need to save money for also when you get down there and stuff too, like, you could always do the layaway plan, which you pay for, like, every 2 weeks. Yes, that really did, like,
because we had $500 just to blow, like, I'm going to the concert.
And it helped you budget your money for the trip itself too, because now you're like working and you're like, all right, I gotta make sure I pay this $90 this week, plus put some money aside, period.
Or you're gonna get that notice, it's cute, ding, 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 the payment has failed. How about the Rolling Loud, it was 4 of us on this trip. The trip was only for us two. We had 2 people coming with us just to go hang out on the beach while we're at the concert. God made a way for them to both get tickets to the concert. So we all was in there. It worked out really well.
It did.
God, he a real one.
Came through.
Real MVP.
Now, this is what to expect once you get down there. All right, once you get down there, if you're planning on being near Rolling Loud, like Miami Gardens, you're cool, you're set, or whatever. But if you were like us who wanted to hang out a bit and also experience the concert, maybe you could get something in Miami Beach. Yeah, do expect to spend that money on that Uber, because originally I think me and her were going to try to be close to Rolling Loud, but being that we had added those 2 people who wanted to just hang out. We had added those 2 people who just wanted to hang out as well. We were just like, okay, let's just be somewhere near for them. And then me and you would just Uber, because regardless, we were going to have to Uber anyway to get to the stadium. So if you are looking to like still have your little fun too, like, I would definitely just get something in Miami Beach and then take that travel to the stadium, especially if you were in a big group like us, because splitting Ubers wasn't too bad. I would say like the Uber is like 30 to 40, but then you split that between 4 people, it's like 10 each of us, so.
Be careful. I think like if we were to plan to go again, we'd get a car. Just because, like, it's probably cheaper paying for gas than keep spending on Ubers. It was like Mm-hmm. Like she said, $30 to $40. It was it's four just of when us. You get so licked, like though. $7 to $10 per person, $12 sometimes. But the Ubers from like at the concert, everybody's trying to get an Uber. Not everybody that's at the concert is staying in that area. So the prices for the Ubers were like $200 for an Uber to take you literally like 10-15 minutes away.
It was bugging.
Come on now.
And then also when you're at Rolling Loud itself, like, it's not as bad. Like, when they say people will be stepping on you, that's only if you trying to get deep down
in the
crowd, at the front of the crowd. Right, like, I barely have people stepping on me. Like, there is a lot of dirt and grass, so you don't want to wear, you know what?
Your shoes don't even get as dirty as you think they will be, though. Because honestly, like, my Vans were already kind of dirty, like, and it's already.
Yeah, wear some Chucks or something, or some Vans. It's not that deep.
It's not. Even if you wear some, like, G-Fazos, they can be recovered after this.
They could be. If you're,
depending on where you're trying to be.
Controlling yourself and what you're trying to do, right? Because
if you're trying to be in the front, you're going to be pushed.
And it, like,
OD. We were, the first day, in the front. Any days after that?
You're mostly going to be in the front at the stages, like the, what's the monster stage and like the small stages where it's like the artists is like where Max. Chief Keef and Waka Flocka was and stuff. But at the
Rolling Loud stage? No.
Yeah. I don't know. You're going to have to camp out or something if you really want to get an Abby. But other than that, they got the big screens for you to see them people. So you good off that. And then,
as far as security, when you're like walking in, you literally just go through a metal detector. They shuffle around a little bit in your bag, so I looking for something
crazy. I took
crazy.
My leave and it was good. It was fine.
I had to go in the sock.
It was all good, but if you're trying to get lit before you go in there,
that's
like,
a pregame.
Yeah, that's a real pregame.
You cannot bring but any that drinks is in there.
It's going to wear off. I'm just letting you know. And like, we only brought a drink in there one time, and that was that. Like,
well, I saw people doing like they let you bring hydration packs, so like those book packs.
And we didn't really know what was in them hydration packs,
right?
So.
I think people had their own little
those things going on, right? Because there's people passing out, so yes, you don't know what they were going through that day. And what they were into, like, so honestly, and it will be a long day depending on who you're trying to see.
What? And that sun is gonna be beaming on you, like.
And then also, so that brings up the time you go, cause being based off who you want to see depends on what the time you go. So like if you want to go early, then most likely if you're there early, you are going to get in the front of wherever, like the Loud stage or whatever first.
So like for instance, like when the people on the lineup. The big name artists perform
later
at night.
Like yeah, so like, the time to show up really would be like 4 or 5 o'clock. Like it's not that deep to show up like real early. That's how we were able to kind of do a little bit of things like beforehand, but most of the time since we were out late the night before, we would wake up at like 12 and have to get ready right away to the concert and just go.
We barely slept.
Our entertainment and whatever fun we had either happened, basically happened after the concert, which we shall get into. Did we leave anything out?
Eat before you go.
Please eat, because they will charge you an arm and a leg just for a burger.
They might let you bring a snack.
Maybe.
If you had it
in
your pocket.
Fanny, whatever. But let me tell you, I spent $15 on a burger.
My hot dog was
$10. I don't ever spend that much money on
beef. They didn't even have ketchup. Had to use mustard. It was good, but like, wasn't even what I was used to.
$15 on some beef? When I can get beef for free?
They sell like those little like shot bottles you see at the liquor store, and they sell like people walking around with like selling beer, all this stuff. But all they tax at the stuff. You can't bring stuff in. You have no choice but to buy there. So they're taxing OD. You're paying $3 more than what you would pay for outside for something like. Get it together, Rolling Loud.
Right.
Nobody wants to pay these prices.
Guys, I just need y'all to see this. Courtney booked everything, right? Look. Why the fuck? That should say Lene Ling. What?